Welcome, let's begin. Symfony is a PHP framework that Drupal borrows from in order to reduce the code duplication across these PHP projects. Much of the code that is borrowed from Symfony is used by Drupal to conduct routing, event handling, the services container, and more. We'll learn about these topics in detail later on in this course. As we go through this video, keep in mind that although a comprehensive knowledge of Symfony is not required to understand Drupal, knowing how Symfony works absolutely will make you a better Drupal developer and an enhanced PHP developer. In this video, we're going to learn about the Symfony framework, why Drupal chose to integrate Symfony and the benefits of this. We'll cover the important components of HttpFoundation, HttpKernel, and routing. We'll examine the HTTP request response communication flow to understand the degree of low-level architecture that Symfony provides and how this enables us as Drupal developers to focus on developing features truly valuable to Drupal and our clients. For historical and confidence purposes, be aware that the decision to build Drupal's infrastructure with Symfony was not taken lightly. For further background on why this decision was made, check out the presentation titled, From Not Invented Here to Proudly Found Elsewhere. A link to that presentation will be provided in the resources at the end of this video. For now though, recognize these benefits of the Drupal Symfony integration decision. Firstly, Symfony provides tools for many of the most common and recurring tasks performed on every web project. Ultimately, Symfony reduces the need to reinvent the wheel, so to speak. A derivative of this is that using Symfony saves us Drupalist time. No longer do we need to spend time writing and maintaining code which solves those common and recurring problems, because that work is already done with high integrity by the Symfony community of developers. Collectively, using Symfony allows us to shift our focus from solving common and recurring problems to developing features that truly add value. Broadly speaking, Drupal is embracing the Symfony vision of common architecture, and Drupal has adopted major Symfony components that allow us to build on that established low-level architecture. Ultimately, Drupal and Symfony projects become more interoperable. That means that you will be able to easily integrate custom Symfony applications with Drupal, and vice versa. Awesome. Further, the Drupal Symfony integration strengthens both communities. They benefit from our coding experience, and they help us improve what we already have. If you wish to experience the official integration announcement from each project founder, Dries Butchart of Drupal and Fabian Potentier of Symfony, blog posts are also provided at the end of this video. For us, as we enhance our Drupal module and development capabilities, before we can actively benefit from Symfony, it behooves us to first recognize the essential elements of the Symfony framework. So let's begin. In general, if you were to ask PHP developers what Symfony is to them, most would say something along the lines of, Symfony is a full-stack web framework written in PHP. Some may also mention that it is an MVC framework, and still others might add that Symfony is a decoupled framework. Now, that is all correct, but according to Fabian, the creator of Symfony, the definition is a bit different. He thinks Symfony is really about two different things. First, Symfony is a reusable set of standalone, decoupled, and cohesive PHP components. Components being a key word here, that solve common web development problems. This, therefore, leads us to his next definition, that based on those components, Symfony is then also a full-stack web framework. With Drupal being a framework itself, both of these perspectives of Symfony are valid. When speaking of Drupal as an application, realize that behind the scene, Drupal is leveraging Symfony as a framework. But taking the perspective of Drupal module development, it's clear that many of Symfony's reusable and standalone components are what we leverage in our module programming. As called out earlier, Symfony components are sets of decoupled and reusable PHP libraries. They are battle-tested in thousands of projects and have been downloaded billions of times. In practical terms, Symfony components have become the standard foundation on which the best PHP applications are built. Each Symfony component has its own Git repository, and they are the result of many years of work through the contributions of many developers. As of today, there are roughly over 50 Symfony components, and Drupal uses around 15 of them. A few of these used by Drupal are class loader, CSS selector, dependency injection, event dispatcher, HttpFoundation, HttpKernel, routing, translation, and YAML. In particular, at this point in our learning process, I want us to pay special attention to these three components: HttpFoundation, HttpKernel, and routing. The HttpFoundation component defines an object-oriented layer for the HTTP specification. The HttpKernel component provides the building blocks to create flexible and fast HTTP-based frameworks. It's the HttpKernel that Drupal expands upon to build the Drupal kernel, which we will learn about later. The routing component maps an HTTP request to a set of configuration variables. We'll also learn about routing in detail later on in this course. For now, let's briefly examine these three components and understand why they matter. The purpose of Symfony's HttpFoundation component is to define an object-oriented approach to communicating with HTTP. As you may recall, HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, and it's a text-based language that allows two machines to communicate with each other. As such, HTTP is the fundamental paradigm that's behind almost all communication on the World Wide Web. Communicating in HTTP with raw PHP is cumbersome and error-prone. With previous, now outdated versions of Drupal, communicating via HTTP was handled through custom Drupal core code, making it brittle for core developers to maintain. Currently, however, because Drupal leverages Symfony, it's the robust HTTP foundation component that is in charge of having Drupal communicate. To appreciate the amount of HTTP communication burden that Symfony relieves Drupal core from, let's recall how HTTP works. As an example, when you visit drupal.org to view the latest updates, the following approximate conversation takes place. First, your web browser inquires the drupal.org server in hopes that it will obtain the appropriate HTML to render the page for you. Second, after receiving your request, the drupal.org server attempts to process what you have requested. Third and finally, if the server is successful in processing the request, it will send back a response. In this case, the response would be something like, "I have successfully found the page you requested. Here is the full HTML for it." Now, whether you realize it or not, HTTP is something you use every day. And it's exciting to know that with Symfony and Drupal, you will learn how to master it. Let's begin our mastery by examining the request and response. Then, we'll go further by analyzing how Symfony components help your Drupal application obtain and process the original request. The first step in the HTTP request response communication flow is that a client sends an HTTP request to a desired server and then patiently waits for a response. Keep in the back of your mind that to deal with these types of messages, Symfony's HTTP foundation component provides a PHP representation of an HTTP request message known appropriately as a request object. The initiating HTTP request itself is entirely a text message, likely readable by a human. Looking at an actual HTTP request, realize that these few lines communicate everything, necessary about exactly which resource the client is requesting. The first line of an HTTP request is the most important because it contains two critical elements: the HTTP method, which in this case is GET, and also the URI, which in this case is the forward slash indicating the front page. As a sanity check, the forward slash is represented fully as drupal.org/. Note, the URI could be anything, and it is relative to the server. For instance, the URI could be a slash, or slash contact, slash blog, slash node, slash one, etc. The URI is the unique address that identifies the resource the client wants. As we have just discovered, the HTTP method defines what the client wants to do with the requested resource. In practice, the HTTP methods are also known as verbs. These define a few common ways that the client can act upon the resource. By far the most common HTTP methods are GET, post, put patch, and delete. The final step in the HTTP request response communication flow is the response of the server. Again, keep in the back of your mind that just like the request object, the HTTP foundation component also provides a PHP representation of an HTTP response message known predictably as a response object. Once a server has received an HTTP request, it knows via the URI exactly which resource the client wants and what the client wants to do with that resource via the method. For instance, in the case of a GET request, the server is to get and prepare the desired resource and return that resource entirely in an HTTP response. Note the contents of an HTTP response contains other information relevant to the response, as well as the requested resource if available. In this example, the full HTML of the Drupal.org page is in the response. And just like the request, the first line of the response is also especially important. In a response message, the first line contains the HTTP response status code. Here, the status code is 200, indicating success in retrieving the requested resource. In this course, it's not necessary to learn the various response codes. It's enough to know that the status code communicates the overall outcome of the request back to the client. As an overview, though, codes in the 200 range indicate that the request was successfully received, understood, and accepted by the server. The 300 range indicates that further action needs to be taken in order to complete the request, such as a 301 permanent redirect. Codes at the 400 level indicate that the request contains bad syntax or cannot be fulfilled. For example, 404 page not found or 403 access denied. 500 level codes indicate a server error. So, as you can determine, this request response conversation is the fundamental process that drives all communication on the web. As a tip, realize the most important fact is this. Regardless of the type of Drupal application you build or the development philosophy you follow, the imperative goal of a web application is always to try and understand each client request and then return the appropriate response. Understand the request and return a response. At this point, we have observed the required request and response messages of the HTTP communication process. By acknowledging Symfony's robust HTTP foundation component, we begin to appreciate the amount of HTTP communication burden that Symfony relieves from Drupal core. So far, we've encountered the request object and response object from the HTTP foundation component. Those are straightforward. The hard part of building an application is developing what comes in between. In other words, the real work comes in writing the code that interprets the request information and creates a response. As I indicated before, the HTTP kernel component and routing component help us with this. We will cover each of those components in detail further in this course as appropriate. For now, suffice it to say that it's the HTTP kernel which orchestrates the process of generating a response from a request. Be excited that the kernel simplifies this process by leveraging what's called the front controller. We'll learn about that soon. Under the hood of the kernel, it's the routing component that is responsible for taking a request and mapping it to a PHP function in charge of creating the expected response. Note that the PHP function is called a controller. We'll learn about these soon. Excellent effort in making it through these essential Symfony concepts. To review, we got familiar with why Drupal chose to integrate the Symfony framework, along with the benefits for doing so. We introduced ourselves to three important Symfony components: HTTP Foundation, HTTP Kernel, and Routing. The HTTP Foundation component provides PHP object-oriented representations of the HTTP messages as request objects and response objects. The HTTP Kernel component provides the building blocks to create flexible and fast PHP frameworks. The HTTP kernel is extended by the Drupal kernel, which we'll learn about later. The routing component maps an HTTP request to a controller, which is in charge of returning a response. We'll also learn about routing in detail later on in this course. That's all for now. I encourage you to browse the external resources provided. I'll see you again soon. Happy learning.